morning, everyone. Good morning, Sharbax.
Hi.
Hi.
So this is the big TCL booth here, CES 2020.
Welcome in Vegas.
You have some really exciting stuff here, huh?
Yes, we have some 8K announcement. We have some mini LED announcement and a lot of QLED. QLED is everywhere, based on quantum dots.
This is really cool. And a lot of people are checking out your cinema wall.
There's that one is micro LED.
So this 132
is different
inch.
From mini LED. Here, every LED is a pixel. So you have 24 million pixels. You have 24 million LEDs. And this is active, meaning it's not a backlight. There is no filter. What you see here is micro LED. It's an innovation, it's a prototype. When the technology will be mature, maybe in 1, 2, 3 years from now, then we will bring it on the market.
Is this the coolest looking micro LED large display in the whole world?
This is one of the coolest. You see a lot of micro LED solutions.
Samsung is showing something.
Oh, exactly, same technology. Same technology. Every brand, every major brand is working on this micro LED technology at the moment.
So it's not quite 8K, but it's definitely going to be 8K.
It's going to be 8K, or by the time we launch it, it's going to be maybe 12K resolution. What I can tell you is we already sold a few pieces, but we need some maintenance.
Yeah? It's very, very, very big.
It's very
potentially
big, very bright.
You can do any size you want.
Yes. And also really good for the resolution. So you can talk, here we show 132 inch, but we also show in the past 150 inch, so much.
And basically it's just tiles, you can put them together as many as you want.
Yes.
And you have small tiles of micro LEDs.
This prototype is made of small tiles, yes. But the target in the end is to make this in a factory, so in one piece. So, but here for the prototype, you see small tiles of micro LEDs, it's easier to maintain and to control.
Maintain, it means sometimes some pixel die and you want to swap out a tile.
Because it's heating a lot, and on this prototype, which is heating a lot, you know, 24 hours a day, sometimes, correct, there might be some tiles to replace.
It looks really impressive. And
really
the,
cool product.
The border around here is much closer than the Samsung demo. That means you're not scared to let people see it.
No,
it
looks
cool.
We are not scared to say it's prototype, it's technology. But in the meantime, we have a very nice one, which is mini LED.
And this is the big, big launch for this show.
Correct.
You're claiming to be the first.
And the only one.
The only one. To
so
do what?
Mini LED
8K or mini LED?
Both, 4K, 8K, and with a quantum dot filter with QLED on top. So what you see here behind me is a 75 inch mini LED first generation.
So what do you mean first generation?
Generation one, which we are actually selling this model. So this model is on the market, 75 inch in the US, 65 inch in Europe. What you have here at the back, 15,000 really small LEDs, and these LEDs are split into zones. We have 800 zones, meaning we can dim and control individually each zone. Great contrast, great brightness, and when the blue LEDs are gonna hit the quantum dot, it's gonna explode into colors. So
800, you say?
800 zones.
Gen 1. First.
Generation one. Generation two,
yeah.
We improve the concept, of course. It's gonna launch by the end of this year.
Yeah.
And then we encapsulate more than 20,000 LEDs in a small sheet of glass. So here you have a sheet of glass. And in this sheet of glass, we encapsulate so many small LEDs, like 20 or 25,000 LEDs.
25,000?
Depending on the screen size. You could even have
so
more.
You're going from 800 to 25,000?
No, that's the amount of LEDs. Then the LEDs are split into zones, and here we are talking about thousands of zones. Yes, so 1,000, 2,000 zones can control individually also. So same as generation one, much more precise, much more dense. The LEDs are smaller, more powerful, and the pitch, so meaning the gap between each LED, much smaller. So we can refine and control the backlight even better.
This is 8K.
This is 8K, more than 2000 nits brightness. And here we're not talking about peak brightness, but average brightness on the screens can be 2000. What you don't see actually is you have a very good transition between the black and the white. You have no halo effect or almost no halo effect. This one is a prototype, but we're going to launch it by the end of the year.
End of the year, not before?
By the end of 2K20.
So,
and then we have a generation 3. We can talk later.
At the press conference, you were...
That's called mini LED on glass. And at the press conference, we call it Vidrian. Vidrian mini LED on glass.
At the press conference, you were kind of teasing Hisense a little bit or somebody else doing dual layer displays. You don't do dual layer. You only do mini LED.
Correct.
You claim it's better. It's brighter.
It's brighter. It's... safer in from an industrial point of view, and it's easier to control together with quantum dots. Of course, I cannot comment on Hisense solution. They may have a good solution, but we think mini LED is a much better solution.
But they claim to have 2 million zones.
Yes, because of this double.
As a full HD zones.
I'm not sure.
They even might do 4K zones eventually.
Yeah, I'm not sure how it works. I need to check out on Hisense.
But no halo, even. It's just thousands of zones.
Just thousands of zones, meaning 2,000 of zones is enough to decrease the halo effect. But on the next generation, we will eliminate the halo effect.
What do you mean next generation?
Generation 3 of mini LED.
You showing something?
Yes, for 2021 or 2022. So meaning in 2 years from now. You know, maybe I have to explain, these products are full array local dimming, FALD, full array local dimming. Meaning the LEDs are placed at the back. It's direct backlight. The challenge here is to make thin products. Generation 1, 2 centimeters instead of 4 centimeters. Generation 2 will go slimmer. And here we have the generation 3, which is less than 5 millimeters. So if you go on the side, here, this is really direct backlight. So the LEDs are placed at the back in a very thin sheet of glass. And the LEDs are closer to the screen to reduce the thickness, less than 5 millimeters. What we also put, we put the speakers in a nice soundbar to make the TV even slimmer.
So slim is a big trend in the last many years, but I think the most important is brightness, quality.
Sorry, I didn't hear.
Most important, I would think, is brightness, quality. How is that? Is that also an improvement?
In terms of picture quality, you have four key things for the human eyes and the brain. You have the contrast, which is the difference between the bright and the dark area. Contrast is probably super important, the most important. Number two, you have the color. The human eyes can really see the colors. Number three, you have the sharpness, so the level of detail, the resolution. And number four, you have the motion on moving pictures, how it behaves without any judder. So these four factors are really very well managed with direct LED solution or mini LED solution. Contrast is really much improved. HDR effect is there. You have all the details on the bright and the dark zones. And the last thing to improve is really on the thickness. Really here you see, you will have much more zones. We are talking about 300K zones.
300,000 zones.
Yes. And the challenge now on this kind of very thin TV, it's heating. It's heating a lot. It's becoming warm.
You don't dare touching it. It gets hot.
Well, you can touch it. No yeah. Problem.
I got static electricity. I can't touch.
Okay, but at the back we put a lot of vents to make the heat escaping at the back.
The vents and the
skinless. You see a lot of I'm not sure if you can see that at the camera. You see a lot of holes at the back here. This is really for the heat to come out.
Nice.
And the nice thing, even in a very slim TV now, we can put the electronics. So all the chassis, what we call the printed circuit board, is still at the back. So when you plug your HDMI and so on, very convenient.
So how does it work, this mini? It's kind of nearly micro LED because you have 300K of them. It's a lot. But mini LED on glass, how is the technology of that doing that?
It's not micro LED. Again, if you look at an 8K TV, you have 33 million pixels.
It's only 300,000.
And here you don't have one LED per pixel. Yeah, it's still a backlight.
It's 100 times less.
Yes.
But it's getting closer.
You could say that. But the result is not that far away. the result is not really not that far away from a micro LED.
The most important is for the consumer and for the user, do they see a difference or they don't?
In terms of contrast, brightness, color, perception, on QLED powered by mini LED, they see a big difference. They even see sometimes a real, benefit versus OLED. So yes, the QLED powered by mini LED, you really see a big difference. You have so many zones and so many brightness and colors. So here what we are also
Let's check the difference between OLED and your mini LED.
Yes.
So you're much brighter basically, no?
On the left,
is that what you would say?
Yes, on the left you see a much brighter and much more detailed picture. When you look at the bright zones, the white zones or the black zones, you probably see more details here. You see more details in the hairs, on the skin, because the HDR is better managed. Of course,
You're not cheating with their demo?
No. Of course, OLED is really good.
OLED
is great.
You have more brightness. What's the nits?
Here we talk about
1200.
Here this is mini LED, first generation, generation one on the market, 1500 nits. Second generation, 2000 nits. Third generation, no limit.
No limit?
No, we will go high.
And this one is capped at 500 to 700 nits?
Yes.
Kind of.
A traditional 55 display, OLED display is...
They don't have a system to go brighter.
No.
It's not possible.
The technology...
You break the OLED.
Not, yes. But the black level are really good. So now, you see or you don't see, but HDR effect might be difficult with the camera to perceive. On the left...
I don't film HDR.
More details on the skin and more 3D HDR effect. You see here, all the details are kind of lost sometimes.
All right.
So out of box settings, dynamic picture on both. You see that mini LED is really quite
last
good.
Last year, with your colleague, American guy, we were talking about the AI.
Yeah.
And I wonder if it was an error. He was talking about that you have some kind of AI that's like much more efficient than H.265 to compress video to like tiny bitrate.
Yes.
Is that real?
Yes. Okay, this one is a technology demo. So the one you are referring to is not this demonstration, it's another demonstration.
Yeah.
It will land in 2K20 this year on the range, on high-end TVs. That one is also really interesting. You have a library of pictures in the TV and on the cloud, so to compare with. And what you can see here, the TV recognizes this is tree, this is leaf, there is brown.
So it optimizes for that?
Yeah, the color saturation is increasing on the brown and the red and increasing on the blue because it detects some water. But the color saturation is okay on the green.
So it keeps adjusting the settings.
It keeps adjusting the settings by picture recognition, by scene recognition, will implement the right settings.
So
same for audio quality.
The codec thing is real, and 2020, what does that mean? Does that mean you're going to enable
this is
new
real.
Systems so for high quality 4K streaming and lower bitrate, or what does it mean?
No,
the other thing I'm talking about.
I mean the codec thing. The first thing?
Codec.
Yes, the codec compression is going to happen at the end of this year.
So what is it going to enable? Like, does that mean you're going to enable better quality 4K streaming?
The benefit for consumers is when you stream some, let's say, low-end YouTube content with a lot of macro blocks, for example, you will have less of these visible macro blocks on the screen. So you will see less of macro block issues, less pixelization on, normal, standard, or low-end content.
But is it a new codec developed by TCL?
Sorry,
it's
again?
A new codec developed by TCL?
No, it's an improvement. It's an improvement of an existing codec.
It's better than AV1, it's better than H.266.
You could say it's the same, it's comparable, but the effect on screen is better. Yes.
Nice. So maybe you contribute all this to like YouTube and Netflix so they can better compress their content.
Yes.
Maybe.
Because not everyone has 8K YouTube or 8K Netflix, not yet on the market.
What's happening here?
Here we have a 100-inch TV with a great sound.
It's 4,000 nits.
Yeah, that TV we sell in China. Under TCL brand, of course.
Very, very bright.
Very bright. Dolby Vision Atmos. But the most impressive part is also the sound, what you cannot hear here. But you see on the left and the right, behind you, on the side, you have these tall boys. And you have a subwoofer here in the middle, giving a great, great sound.
So at TCL, you don't only want to do soundbar stuff, which a lot of people are doing. It's nice to have real surround sound, real speakers, to say. Not just little things that you put under the TV. Well, you want to have real speakers for the
both.
Best experience.
We do both. We often, below the TV, we often include a soundbar. We integrate a soundbar. Sometimes we integrate it in a flush way, or in a more prominent way, like what you see here. And we also sell individual soundbars, of course.
Is that your screen? What's this? No,
that's not from TCL.
It's another friendly company over there.
I think it's from the CS.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry.
And the next big news, we discussed 8K, we discussed mini LED. The other big news is quantum dot TVs, QLED TVs.
But all of those that you've shown until now, are they all quantum dot or not?
Yes, but I was showing 8K. I was showing mini LED, so let's say very good, innovative, the best picture quality, let's say. Here, what we have is more affordable quantum dot TVs. So these quantum dot TVs come with 100 Hertz, so they are really good quantum dot.
100 or 120 for the US, right?
Yeah, 120 in the US, 100 Hertz in Europe.
And this is 75 inch.
It's 75, 65, and 55. We have three screen sizes, and it's kind of QLED plus, let's say, because 100 Hertz, 100% color volume, very bright screens. On the other side, we have even more affordable QLED TVs, no 100 Hertz, 50 Hertz, very slim. What you can see here is probably one of the most competitive QLED TV range on the market when we launch it in April and May.
82 inch, 65.
82 for the US, and in Europe we will have a 75, a 65, a 55, and a 50. Most probably, still under discussion, three sizes for Europe, 50, 55, 65. We are also targeting, more affordable prices on these kind of QLED models.
So
it's a really
talking.
It's really good QLED. Really good QLED quality, very good, with a lot of innovation inside, hands-free, we can talk more, Android and so on. But this kind of TV will target the price of a normal TV. So almost QLED for free. We will see how the market is moving, but we are preparing, our mission is to democratize the technology to make quantum dot affordable. So that everyone can afford the quantum dot.
So 65 inch quantum dot for $499. No,
how much? Did you say again?
499, 65 inch quantum dot.
Way cheaper.
Cheaper?
No, 1499 you said, or 499?
499.
No, 55, 4599.
Okay.
Depending on the competition again.
Yeah, 65 is a little bit more.
It depends when the market will be.
And below 1000.
65 might be or will be below 1000, we think. Yes.
799.
We don't know yet, to be honest. We really don't know yet. We are in January, we're going to introduce this range in April, May. Many things can change before the Euro Cup. You know that the market price are really aggressive. We will be there at the right level of price. This is our mission in TCL. We will never make super high quantum dot.
Brightness is good on those cheap ones?
But again, those cheap ones are really good quality.
Is it 1000 nits or no?
It's 800.
800.
800 nits, so very good brightness. 100% color volume, because it's quantum dot. Yeah.
Why can't we get the big ones in Europe? Why do you just sell them to the Americans?
The market.
Because
the market
we also love big.
Here it doesn't look big, but in your flat, in my flat,
it's too big?
In your castle, in your big home, maybe good enough. But not
it's
so
not
many
castles.
People.
All the castles are in Europe.
No.
There's no castles in the US.
Only a few customers, that's not enough. We need more and bigger homes in Europe. In USA, everyone can accept this. No, to be honest, even in USA, this 82-inch might be still
overkill
for next year. So
but,
the year after, 2021.
Can you estimate around how much would the 82-inch quantum dot be for the US? How much is the price? Is it $1499?
I cannot comment at all. I have no clue here in the US.
It's Americans who deal with
because it's Americans. We have to ask our
So
American
you don't have
colleagues.
Space in the containers, shipping containers. When you go to Europe, there's no space for the big one.
No, that's
right
not
now.
A big deal. But I advise we talk to Bruce later for the USA range. You can easily talk to Bruce.
All right, we can catch up with him later. How about here, these?
So for Europe,
how about these?
About these? This one? So this one, they come
price
with,
around.
For Europe, they come with Android 9, compatible Android 10, 11. They also come, very interesting here, what you can see, they come with a soundbar. In the soundbar, we include a microphone. We call it
nice.
Hands-free voice control. So now you can say, hey Google, to wake up your TV and change channel, open Netflix. You don't need your remote control or your smartphone anymore.
You and talk you can speak Alexa with it also. If you prefer to speak Alexa, you can do it also.
Both Alexa compatible and Google Assistant compatible.
You can even speak both at the same time.
No,
hey Google, what time is it? Hey Alexa, record the TV show.
You can do that because they have different skills. Alexa skills and Google Assistant skills are quite different. And of course, you can use both. The only difference is when you use a Google Assistant, then you talk directly to the TV. You say, hey Google, or you can use your remote control. If you use the Alexa, the work with Alexa, you still have to plug an Echo Dot to it. So you plug it, and then you can say, hey, hey Google, you say, Alexa, change channel. Alexa, open Netflix.
So I'm not to say anything bad about Roku. Roku is great and stuff. But sometimes you do
US?
Roku in the US.
So
but in Europe, we get Android.
Yes, in Europe,
which is great.
Android is really big, really useful. This is probably the best OS so far that we can have here in Europe. How to say? Android system, Android TV, is very much evolutive. You have updates and you have upgrades. But this is the biggest amount of applications you can dream. You have the Amazon Prime, you have the Netflix, you have all the latest applications on Android
and,
TV.
Google
and the
has
convenient,
done a, Google
so
has
the
done a good job in the last year, a couple of years, to improve the Android TV experience.
I think you are raising a valid point. At the really beginning, if we go 4 or 5 years back, it was the first time we launched Android TV. Let's say other brands launched Android TV 5. Was not ready. Android 6 was quite slow, but from Android 7 and 8, you see a lot of improvements. The operating system has improved so much between Android 5, 6, and then 7, 8 is really optimized for TV. At the beginning, what the makers, TV makers were doing, they were just porting Android mobile phone into a TV, which didn't work that well. But that was Android 5 and 6. Later, we developed specific Android TV versions, 7, 8, and 9, and this is really working fast and really good at the moment. And you see the sales of Android TV raising up in Europe.
Consumers are happy.
Yeah, really happy. We have really good feedback on that.
Nice.
Because you find all your applications, you have many useful features like, you know, the Google Home, you can control your curtains, your coffee machine, your fridge via Google Home. You can enjoy games, you have 4K HDR on Netflix, Dolby Vision on Netflix, HDR 10 Plus on Amazon Prime, so many applications and games compared to other systems.
Because we go here,
tell me, sir.
TCL is doing lots of smart home things, no?
Correct.
There's you can connect the lights, you can connect humidifier, the air purifier.
Yeah. So what we are showing here is a connected home with some fun stuff, detection. We can train
nice.
Gym if you like.
It's very cool.
It's very cool.
It's so, just an app on Android TV. It's just an app. This right?
It's an app, and sometimes it's a chipset which we include in. In all these devices, in all these TCL devices, you have a small chipset so that they can intercommunicate as an ecosystem.
And here is even the whole TCL kitchen with a smart, what do you call it, the hub? The thing there. Smart fridge.
Smart fridge over there.
Smart fridge. Smart cooking, smart
yes.
doors.
You have smart curtains, smart lamps.
TCL is a market leader in China for these smart doors.
The smart
selling
lock.
Any in Europe, maybe?
It's called the smart lock. Only in China at the moment. We are considering
Europe, no?
We are discussing with customers to introduce this in Europe,
nice.
But we don't have any agreement yet.
This could be a smart mirror in front of the bathroom and the air
conditioning system. And over there, you have also a part of the smart home where you can control, you know, the lamps or the popcorn coffee machine via the Google Home system.
Nice. So I did another video in Shenzhen. People can check
you already
it out.
Made this.
And with all the AI. And
yes.
If you don't mind, we can go walk around
we
over
continue
here.
Over there.
You have a strange,
this is
a very
really
cute
fun.
Dog. What is this about?
This is about, you
TV.
Know, when you look at younger generations today, when they snap or when they do some Facebook Messenger or so on, they very often use the portrait or the landscape mode. Yeah, both. This TV will react to your content on your mobile phone automatically. So
nice.
if you shake your mobile phone, for example,
how do you make it turn?
I will ask the lady if she's here. Do you have the mobile for the demo?
All
we
right.
can have a short demo here, I think.
Let's go to the other one. I can show you on the other screen.
Let's go there. Yes.
Yeah. So then the phone is paired with your
the phone
TV.
Is paired with the TV,
and then some kind of shake happens.
So here you shake on the phone and then
there's a motor turning the TV.
And you see a very nice sound bar at the back. You have a very good sound also.
Nice. And then you have to enter the AI right there. And you can shake it back to puppy upright mode.
Yes. And there is also a possibility that when you change from portrait to landscape, the TV will also change the format automatically.
Nice. Then we keep going around.
Yep.
This is the whole big push by TCL to launch smartphones,
so
launch earphones.
Are always the new coming with smart speakers. This is really fun.
TCL earphones.
Fun TCL earphones, full of colors. We call them Intra. And we spent a lot of time on this part here, because this part should be really gentle to the inside of your ear. The weight. So the weight, this part, should be on the outside of your ear. Because the human ear, my human ear, your human ear, is not prepared to support any weight on the inside.
Nice.
So we spend a lot of time to optimize the shape here, so that when you put it in your ear, really, the weight is supported by the outside and not by the inside.
So with TCL, people are not going to get strange ears out of using these kind of things.
No, it's very
which is going to happen with Apple and
that
all the other
one
ones.
I can't say on
I'm joking
Apple,
a little bit.
But that one is really comfortable.
Well engineered.
These kind of headphones are really great. You have two range of product. This one will be like introduced in March, April in Europe, around 79 euros. So very good.
And you gave one to every media at your press conference.
No, we're not buying medias, my friend. We are.
You gave one.
But for testing, yes.
For testing,
for
yeah.
Testing.
So I have one. I'm going to review it very soon.
So
we're going to test out the quality.
Euros, I think you got them at the press conference. And we got also the sports mode over there. The sport one, sorry. This one is going to be like more 99 euro in Europe. It comes with the charger, of course. You have very good autonomy. Yeah, it's splash-proof, sweat-proof,
and the quality hopefully is great.
The sound quality you're gonna tell us very soon. I guess
I'm starting to testing
but
already.
But you will hear it.
Nice. Battery life is good, long, and everything.
And then talking about sound quality.
Yeah,
we have the best sound bar of the show.
Already?
Yes. Here. This is considered already at IFA. We got 5 awards. Best soundbar of IFA. Again here in Vegas. This is the best soundbar of the show. Maybe you can decrease a little bit. Can you decrease a little bit? No. What is really nice in this soundbar here is that we have deflectors. So most of the soundbars are doing virtualization, you know? It's an algorithm to do Atmos, left, right, virtualization. Here, this soundbar is not virtual. This is a mechanical principle with deflectors. The sound flow, you can feel the sound flow going on the left, going on the right to the wall and reflecting.
To do better surround kind of effects without
yes,
surround.
Because when you hear, when you send the flow, when I talk to you like this, you understand me, if I talk to you like this, or if I talk to you like this, then you don't understand me anymore. So it's a basic principle, but that's the only soundbar in the world doing this. Deflectors, the flow is standing there. Of course, in the middle, you still have middle speakers for the clarity, for the voice, and for the dialogue.
Is this going to be affordable?
This is called Radens. This is TCL Radens, affordable, less than 400 euro, probably 399, launching in Q1, so March, April.
Nice. Let's check some of the phones, even though it's not your segment.
Right.
But let's go over there, because TCL is big, going big time on the phones.
Yeah, we have announced. So 6 months ago in Europe, at IFA, less than 6 months ago, September, we announced
the Plex.
Launched the Plex in Germany, Spain, and now we are launching in USA, here in USA. This is TCL Plex. So really good picture quality and camera.
Is it called Plex or is it a different name now?
That's a good question. We are thinking maybe to use a different name. Yes.
Yeah. So you have one with a little dot in the corner.
Yeah.
And it's a high quality build.
It's nice called a notch.
TCL quality display, right?
Yes, it's TCL display, and we use what we call a chipset called Next Vision. This is all the experience we have in TV in terms of HDR. We bring it to the mobile. So that mobile has a HDR quality. On the display.
But the price is half of an iPhone, or maybe less. It's like a good price, no?
I think it's even, depends which iPhone you take, but of course it's TCL and it's affordable technology.
And any chance to try the
you will see more in Barcelona?
You're talking about a foldable phone. Any chance you might have one you're showing to people?
If you come in Barcelona at the Mobile World Congress, we will reveal and we will announce much more details on this foldable phone.
So it's going to be a cool foldable phone. Hopefully it's not going to cost $2,500 like Huawei or Samsung. Maybe more affordable, hopefully.
You know us.
But the quality is hopefully good.
The quality is going to be under control. It comes also from our display factories. So the power of TCL is that we are not only doing the hardware and the software, but the main power of TCL is that we are using our own displays. So we control what we buy, we control what we do, because we control the display. We are vertically integrated from display until the product.
Not many companies are like this in the world.
Only three in the world. Only three electronic companies in the world are vertically integrated. Two are Korean.
Samsung and LG.
Yeah, and one Chinese, TCL.
And all the other brands in the whole world
have to buy.
They buy from a different supplier.
Yes, from five, six different.
It could be BOE, for example, who doesn't make their own brand.
Could be TCL, CSOT factories.
So you ship to other companies too?
Yes, we ship displays to any company, any competitor. In this industry, we share displays sometimes. But in TCL, we mostly use our own displays because we really want to control the quality, the technology, innovation, and ultimately have an affordable price over there.
Thanks a lot for making these amazing displays, because it's great there's 7 billion people in the world and everybody enjoys displays, and it's nice that somebody is thinking about doing them affordable. Right, not just
good quality.
I'm not going to complain too much about some of the Korean displays, but sometimes they're very expensive. I mean, they also have different SKUs for all these different markets.
Yes.
But affordable is great. So everybody can afford a nice 8K QLED.
Not only affordable, really good quality also.
Good quality.
Yes, at an affordable price.
You're going to be number one eventually? You are number one.
We have some countries where we are really number one or two. Example, USA. Also in France, we are number three in TV on the market because we have a TCL and Thomson brand, for example. So we are the number three TV seller. So we have some countries where when we invest, really, you see the sales really growing fast. So China is one of these. USA is a key country. In Europe, you have France, Germany, UK, where TCL is growing constantly, yes, and quite fast. Faster than the market, at least.